Alright, what is going on guys? Gino Checker back in for another video today, and in this video I'm going to be bringing you guys through yet another full day of eating. Alright, so to give you guys some more information about me at the moment, I'm currently around 4 weeks out from my first ever natural bodybuilding competition. I have 4 weeks left to get in the best shape of my life and to bring a adequate enough physique to present myself on the stage for the first time ever. Now, I've been cutting for the past around 13 weeks. I started my contest prep at around 17 weeks out, and I've been able to get quite lean already. And everything that I'm going to be showing you guys in this video today is exactly what got me into the shape that I am currently. Now, I do follow flexible dieting, so that means that my food isn't exactly the same every single day, but there are some staples in my diet that I pretty much have every single day that allow me to stick to my diet, not be hungry all the time, and simply make the diet a lot more enjoyable. I'll go a lot more in depth in the video to actually explain to you guys how much I'm eating, what I'm doing exactly, and the meals that I'm consuming. So without further ado, let's start this full day of eating. All right, what's going on guys? Gino Checker back in for another video today. It is, let me see, 8:47 a.m. and it's, let me check again, the 19th of March. It's a Tuesday. Had a low weigh-in yesterday, so I'm really excited to see how much I weigh today. That is a new low weigh of 84.0 kilograms, and I'll put the pounds on the screen right here. So ever since I've lowered my calories, I've been dropping weight very steadily, and that is exactly how it should be going. You know, once you reach a plateau, you're supposed to only drop like 100 calories or add a little bit of cardio, which comes down to the same as dropping your calories with 100 per day. And that should just bust you through your fat loss or your weight loss plateau. So as you can see, I'm dropping weight, I'm losing more and more fat, and I'm getting more and more ready for the stage. 4 weeks out. Since coffee, not just caffeine, actually helps fight the hunger feeling and kind of blunts your appetite, I make sure to drink like 2 or 3 cups of coffee, big cups, when I'm fasting to fight the hunger and make the fasting a lot easier.
So we have a big cup of coffee about to go down.
I love coffee, man. Alright guys, so I've been home for a couple of hours, been doing some work on the computer, and it's now time for the first meal of the day at 1 p.m. Now, for those who have been following my channel for a longer while and actually watched a lot of my other full day of eating videos, this might be a surprise for some of you. I've actually been eating oats for the past week or something instead of my usual all bran bowl. This just fills me up a little bit better than the usual all bran that I eat, and it's warmer. Especially when you're getting a lower body fat, you tend to be cold like 24/7, so this allows me to stay warm, heat my system up a little bit, and feel more full for the first meal of the day. So you might be asking yourself, what's in the bowl? I have 100 grams of oats, just heated up with hot water. 2 bananas, which came down to around 210 grams of banana. 40 grams of whey. 20 grams of cacao powder. 10 grams of almonds. As you can see, almonds. I added in a little bit of cinnamon, a little bit of Himalayan salt, a little bit of sweetener, and I topped it off with 10 grams of chocolate sprinkles. Now, a lot of you guys actually tell me that this meal looks like actual crap, but trust me, it tastes so good. And once you add in the cacao powder and the chocolate tasting whey, it actually tastes as if you're just eating chocolate, but then, you know, a little bit more healthy, and allows you to hit your macros a lot better as well. So do not knock it till you try it. And if you try it out and you like it, please let me know in the comments. And even the legendary Nutella sandwich is something that I have been eating every single day of my prep. You do not have to skip out on all the dirty foods or unhealthy foods. At the end of the day, it's all about energy balance. You know, as long as you're in a caloric deficit, you can eat whatever you want, but not in the amounts that you might want. So I've just been eating 2 slices of bread with 30 grams of Nutella, and that allows me to not crave it, just eat it, and make the diet a lot more sustainable and enjoyable. Alright, so in order that you guys have a clear idea on what I'm doing exactly in order to get contest shredded, I have a whiteboard right here, and I have my exact game plan that I have been following and am following currently in order for me to reach the conditioning that I want. So let's just first and foremost start off with nutrition. As you can see, I'm eating 2600 calories at the moment. This is the amount of calories that I take in, and it's not my net total calories for the week in terms of a deficit, since I do some cardio during the week, and that is actually a part of my deficit, but I'll go more in depth on that as I go through the whiteboard. 2600 calories, 190 grams of protein. Now that has stayed consistent throughout my entire prep, and that is around 1 gram per pound of body weight, or 2.2 grams per kilogram of body weight for me personally, since I now weigh 84 kilograms and I started at 90.5 kilograms. I'm eating 325 grams of carbohydrates. Now this might come across as a shocker for a lot of people, since carbs tend to be quite low when you want to get shredded, but you're better off keeping your carbs as high as possible while you're still losing fat, since it's not about the amount of carbs or the amount of fat, it's about the total caloric deficit you're in. As long as you're in a deficit, you will lose fat. And since carbs are the main driver of your performance, in terms of how much glycogen you have inside of your muscles that deliver the amount of energy that you can give during your workout, you're better off having your carbs as high as possible. Allows you to not be flat all the time and keep your performance in the gym as high as possible as long as you can. Then I have 60 grams of fat. Now, me personally, I do not go below 50 grams of fat. 60 grams is actually my minimum amount, since fats are responsible for the production and regulation of the hormones in your body. So, for example, the hormone testosterone is primarily regulated by the amount of fats that you're eating. So if you go very low fat, it won't be beneficial for your hormone production. And especially when you get leaner and actually like dip below 10% body fat into the single digit body fat levels, you're better off keeping your fats a little bit higher, or at least not below 50 grams, in my opinion, in order to keep that production of hormones going properly. So that is my diet in terms of numbers. I make sure to reach this amount of calories, this amount of macros, while I'm utilizing intermittent fasting. Now I have a full video going in depth on what intermittent fasting actually is and what it can potentially do for your fat loss and your results in general. So I'll link that in the cards anywhere here in the corner, so you can check that out and get a lot more knowledge on intermittent fasting. Now what I typically do is I wake up at around 8 a.m. and I start eating my first meal of the day at 1 p.m. Now this is because I like to train at around 3 p.m. So in order for my body to kind of digest the first meal and actually let the carbs hit my system, refill my glycogen before hitting the workout, I like to have around an hour and a half up to 2 hours before I actually go to the gym. So I fast for around, 5 or 6 hours, depending on how late I wake up. And then I have my cardio. Now I do 4 sessions of 265 calories per week, which comes down to 1050 calories for the total of the week. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning of this clip, this all adds up to my total deficit for the week. So I'm eating 2600 calories, which is already in a deficit for me personally. And I take 3 or 4 30 to 40 minute walks outside. Now this is a very low intensity, and I've actually been doing this as of this week that the video is coming out on YouTube. So this is pretty new, and it allows me to kind of speed up the process, lose a little bit more fat in a faster rate, and actually be ready soon enough for stage. So that's my nutrition and my cardio. Now in terms of intensity for the cardio, I like to keep it at around MISS, or medium intensity steady state cardio. I'm not that big of a fan of HIIT cardio, since it kind of taps into my recovery for the next workout, since my legs are already pretty sore on medium intensity. So I like to just keep it that way. Now in terms of my training, I'm training 5 times per week, and the split that I'm currently running is Monday upper, and I have the bench focus. Tuesday lower, which is a squat focus. Wednesday is my off day, which I usually do cardio on. Thursday is my upper body workout with the overhead press. Friday is my lower body workout, which revolves around the stiff legged deadlift. Saturday is my upper day, which is kind of a hypertrophy style based workout. I don't really have a specific compound movement on the day since I already had the most important work for the week done by all of these 4 days in total, and Monday I repeat the whole schedule. One thing that I actually forgot to put on the whiteboard right here is every Saturday I have a refeed day. Now on my refeed day, what I do is I bring up my calories to around maintenance and I up my carbs to whatever that amount may be. So for me personally, that is around 450 up to 500 grams of carbs. Now for the last couple of weeks of this prep, so the coming weeks, I'm going to keep it at 450 or slightly above that to not go too much overboard and simply just lose the amount that I still have to lose to get ready on time. Alright guys, so I just came back from the gym, and one of the many things that I enjoy about intermittent fasting is especially the post-workout meal. Since when you've used up so much energy, it feels so good to be able to feast on so much food. And as you can see by the volume of this meal, I'm not going to be hungry anytime soon. So what I have right here is 350 grams of white cooked potatoes along with some pepper and some salt, around 100 grams of green beans, around 220 grams of carrots, 165 grams of chicken with some sriracha and some 50% reduced sugar ketchup. That's a mouthful. A big bowl of spring mix with some Nando's hot sauce and some 50% reduced sugar ketchup on top of it. Around 250 grams of mixed frozen berries. This is 400 grams of quark, but I'm also going to be adding another tub on top of what's already in here. And 3 rice cakes with 20 grams of peanut butter. And that's basically all there is to it. I have 2 meals a day. Now, as long as I'm hitting my macros and my calories at the end of the day, it does not matter how many meals I eat or in what order or what form or whatever. Macros and calories are king. And this allows me to stick to my diet a lot easier since a couple of weeks before this, I actually just ate like 3 or 4 meals a day and I ended up being really hungry at the end of the day. So this way of dieting is my personal preference and it allows me to actually get the results that I want easier without struggling with the hunger feeling. Alright, and that is everything that I am eating in order to lose fat and get shredded. Now, like I said, I am 4 weeks out from my first ever natural bodybuilding competition. Now, in order for me to keep making progress throughout this contest prep, I make sure that I track my progress. So I weigh myself every single day, I track my weekly averages, compare those, and if I am not losing weight and losing fat on the rate that I want to, by around 0.5 kilogram or 1 pound per week, I drop my calories or I add cardio. But these changes are small. What I see a lot of people do is make drastic changes when you're not making the progress that you want or you're not making any more progress. Just drop your calories by 100 if you're already in a deficit, and that will allow you to bust through that fat loss plateau and make more progress. As a kind of rule of thumb, you should always eat as much as possible while you're still losing body fat. So say for example, if your maintenance is around 3,000 calories, then just Go 2500 for the first couple of weeks. Keep track of your progress, see if you're losing fat. And if you've plateaued, just simply drop to 2400 or add a little bit of cardio. And the main reason for this is that you want to give yourself time. If you drop to like 1800 calories straight away, you will lose fat and lose weight pretty quickly, but eventually you will plateau. The human body is always going to be adapting to whatever you give it. So if you give it 1800 calories, that is close to your BMR. And if you drop any lower than that, your body will not want to lose fat, because the primary role of the human species in general is to survive. And if you're not giving your body enough energy to even function properly, so underneath your BMR, you're not going to be losing fat because your body wants to hold on to everything that it has at that particular moment. So slow and steady always wins the race. So that is it for this video, guys. I sincerely hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please be sure to smash the like button, because it really helps out the channel grow. Comment down below and subscribe to the channel for so much more content coming really soon. I'm out, guys, and peace out. See you in the next one.